Can you see this screen? Okay. So good. Okay. So that's it. We are going to analyze the previous 9-year question paper of science and technology asked by UPSC from 2011 to 2019. Okay. So unlike the previous sessions like environment and world history or any other Indian geography and other sessions, I would say that unfortunately there is not that many trends and patterns in science and technology. Okay, so let me turn off the annotations. So thanks for reminding me that. Okay, so unlike other subjects like environment, modern Indian history or Indian geography, it's very unfortunate that in science and technology there are not many trends and patterns. Okay, so that is a very unfortunate thing, because science and technology, as you all know, this is a content oriented paper. This is a content oriented paper. If you have the content, if you know what a particular technology or a scientific principle is, you can go with that question. Okay, so that is the nature of this particular subject in UPSC exam. Okay, so there is no use in showing you the weightage of questions or the different type of questions or the different tendencies or groups of questions, group of topics in science and technology to analyze this particular subject, because there is actually not that much trend. Okay, so that's why I have avoided the graph. Okay, I have avoided the graphical representation. I have avoided the sectional division. Okay, so these kind of usual theory of prelims things I have avoided, because there is not such huge trends and patterns which we can follow. The only thing you have to get is good content. Okay, so content will only help you in science and technology questions. So if you want to get an ideal number of questions which will be asking by UPSC every year, it will be around 12 to 15. Okay, so number of science and technology questions would be around 12 to 15 every year. But last year in 2019, we saw a spike of questions, a huge number of questions, which went up to 19. Last year in 2019, the number of science and technology questions went up to 19. Okay, so it was only year we got as many number of questions from science and technology. Otherwise, in all other years, questions were usually hovered around 12 to 15. Okay. So we'll try to find out whether there is any particular trend, or if we can find out any, or whether there are any areas which we have to focus. So those kind of things we'll find out here. So the mode of today's discussion would be, I'll be showing you some previous year questions, which are having some common traits. Okay. Some common things in all those questions. I'll be showing a group of such questions, and I'll be recommending you to where to focus. Okay, because this is a very dynamic subject, it will be better if I'm giving a area which you should be focused. Okay, so the nature of today's discussion will be, I'll be giving you some sessions, I'll be showing you some questions, and later I'll show you, or I'll tell you how to focus or where to focus on these particular areas. So that will be the mode of discussion. Getting it? So I hope you got a thought, overall idea about this particular session. We won't be having any defined or definite trends and patterns in science and technology. All we have to do is find out some focus areas, find out some special areas where UPSC will focus. Then we have to focus. We do have to focus on that particular area. Getting it? So first one. So let me move to the first technology, public utility technologies by government. Okay, this is an area I have to identify first. Public utility technologies by government. So are you with me? Can you give me a reply or something? Okay. because I'm not seeing you. Okay, great. I'm getting replaced. Thank you. So this is the first session, Public Utility Technologies by Government. So please do remember that there won't be any YouTube sessions or any recorded sessions. So make sure you are writing or you are scribbling all the important things from here itself. Okay. So there won't be any separate YouTube session for this. So the first focus area should be Public Utility Technologies by Government. So this will be the first area where you should focus. Okay. So in today's session, focusing on these questions is not that much important, or solving these questions is not that much important, because if you have the content, you can solve these questions. Okay. If you have the knowledge about a particular technology, if you have the knowledge about a particular content, you can solve it. Otherwise, you can leave it. That is the nature of these questions. So the entire focus of this discussion would be telling you where to focus. Getting it? So this is an area where you can invest your time on, Public Utility Technologies by Government. Okay. So UPSC asked question about DigiLocker. UPSC asked question about Bheem app, and UPSC asked question about National Payment Corporation of India, and another thing, again UPSC asked about Unified Payment Interfaces. Okay, so in four different years, UPSC asked these four different questions: a question regarding UPI, a question regarding National Payment Corporation of India, and another question regarding DigiLocker, and another question regarding Bheem app. So these were the questions you got, or we got, in four different years. Okay. So each year government focused a particular technology, a particular e-governance technology where we can use, which can be used to improve the governance. It can be financial governance, can be economic governance. So whatever be the area, in every different year, government focused on a particular technology. Okay. So just like DigiLocker, Bheem app, National Payment Corporation of India, a broad question, a general question, and specifically about UPI. So the best thing, so if you have the knowledge about this technology, if you know about DigiLocker, you can solve it. If you know about Bheem app, you can solve it. And if you know about UPA, you can solve it. Okay, so there is no tricks here. So the best part is where to focus, knowing where to focus. The source is important for these kind of questions. So this is a source they have been picking up questions: National Payment Corporation of India and its official website. So this is one such website you can use to find out topics. Okay. So National Payment Corporation of India, its official website. Let me show you its official website. Okay. I hope you are seeing this official website. Aren't you? Are you able to see this official website? Okay, so this is the official website of National Payment Corporation of India, and you can see a tab there, what we do. What we do. Getting it? So there is a tab here, what we do. See, look at the pop-ups that came out. Look at the pop-ups. There is UPI. There is Bheem app. You can see it. Okay, so two such topics are there: UPI and Bheem app, which got asked in previous 2 years, were in this particular website. And again, National Payment Corporation of India itself. Okay. In fact, three of the questions asked from these government utility technologies were picked up from this particular website. Getting it? So in exam point of view, this is an important website you can follow. So there are other questions they can ask. There are other topics they can ask questions from, they can frame questions from. Getting it? See, look at each of the options given there. UPI, it asked once. RuPay cards, it asked once. Bheem app, it asked once. Then you can expect a question, NETC. NETC, can you see NETC here? NETC, otherwise known as, also known as the FASTag. FASTag. So this year you can expect a question from FASTag. Okay, NETC. Okay, if you can see that, are you able to see that tab NETC fast track, the highlighted one? You can see it, right? Okay. So this is the thing you have to focus this year. Fast track, you can expect a question this year. Okay, so you can see an FAQ tab here, right? FAQ tab here. So if you open that FAQ tab, you'll be getting all the basic information about fast track. Okay, here you can see an FAQ tab here. If you open that FAQ tab, you'll be getting every basic information regarding fast track. So that is one important topic for this year, NETC or fast track. Then you can see Bharat Bill Pay system there. Bharat Bill Pay system here, just below NETC, you can see a Bharat Bill Pay system. Another what? E-governance project. Getting it? So you can expect a question from Bharat Bill Pay. Then you can see that highlighted one, Aadhaar enabled payment system. You can expect a question from that one too. Aadhaar enabled payment system. You can expect a question from that one too. And finally, this one, Bharat QR. Bharat QR. Bharat QR code. So these are the areas you have to focus. If you get time, go through all the technologies given in this tab. From UPI to Bheem Aadhaar. Otherwise, focus on these three or four things which I have said to you. Getting it? Bharat QR code, Aadhaar enabled payment system, then fast track mechanism, and Bharat Bill payment system. So these are the things you have to focus. Getting it? So if you are getting enough time, go through all these technologies, all these payment services. Otherwise, focus on these three specific things. Getting it? So this was a particular website where UPSC used to pick up topics. Getting it? So I hope it's clear, right? Are you able to hear me? Okay. So getting it. So this was the first area I have to show you. So let me move to the PowerPoint again. See, we saw about National Payment Corporation of India and its website. So this was one such area. Then moving into another thing, data transfer technology. See, these are all random areas. We cannot find a specific correlation between the sections. These are all random areas. So I have grouped all the questions asked in last 9 years into different sections, which is actually having no interconnection. Okay, this is just a random classification. Getting it? So the second section is data transfer technology. Data transfer technology. Remember, I'm not going to solve all the questions here, because if you have the knowledge about these technologies, you can solve it. Okay, I'm only what? Guiding you through the focus point. Okay, I'm not going to solve these questions. So second one is data transfer technologies. So in a particular year, UPSC asked about near field communication. Okay, near field communication. I think this was asked in 2012 or 13, I think. Okay, so near field communication, UPSC asked about near field communication. Then in next year, the very next year, UPSC asked about Wi-Fi devices, difference between Bluetooth and Wi-Fi devices, to focus on Wi-Fi. So in 1 year, UPSC asked about near field communication. In another year, UPSC asked about Wi-Fi devices. Next year in 2016, UPSC asked about Li-Fi. Okay, so all these are advanced technologies, right? So from near field communication to Wi-Fi technology, from Wi-Fi to Li-Fi technology, all these are what? Continuous evolution of some data transfer technology, right? So UPSC used to focus on these kind of technology, emerging technologies of that particular year. Getting it? So what would be the next? That is my question. If UPSC is choosing to follow this pattern, what would be the next topic? That is my question. There are plenty of data transfer technologies in 2020. So what would be some of those technologies we can use to transfer data? Can you give me some suggestions? Yeah, 5G is there. Then more. I'm expecting some replies from you. Blockchain for security, not actually. Just focus on this data transfer technology. Yeah, WiMAX is there. Good. More suggestions. Yeah, fiber tech, quantum computing. So these are all diverse topics. Just focus on this particular data transfer technology. Technologies like NFC, Wi-Fi, Li-Fi, cloud computing, entirely different topic. Yeah, these are my suggestions. Okay, so please wait. The screen is changing actually. So let me pause the share. Then let me share it again. Okay. So are you able to see these technologies? Are you able to see this? So these are my suggestions. Okay. KISS connectivity, a new form of near field communication. WiMAX technology, an advanced version of Wi-Fi. Optical wireless communication. Another technology. Edge computing. Another technology. Then transfer of data over voice or sound. This is possible. Transfer of data over sound. Okay. So KISS connectivity, edge computing, WiMAX, optical wireless communication, transfer of data over sound or voice. So these are some of the suggestions I can give you. And please do remember these suggestions are based on current affairs till April 2020. Okay. So these are the suggestions based on April 2020. So if there is any such current affair after April, so you have to follow it year on. So these are suggestions based on current affairs till April 2020. Okay. So among these technology, edge computing is one particular area you have to focus this year. Getting it? Edge computing is one such area you have to focus this year. See, it won't be possible to teach what is edge computing in this particular session, because the purpose of the session is not to teach you something, but to help you identifying some of the important topics for your exam. Okay, so please do understand that. Okay, I won't be able to teach what is edge computing in this particular session. So focus on edge computing. This particular technology can be asked in the coming years, UPSC's exam. So these are some of the data transfer technology you can use to what you can study, you can invest your time. Getting it? So clear? Is the discussion okay? Are you getting things? Are you able to understand things? Okay. So the next one. So we have seen public utility technologies by government and some of the data transfer technologies of last, 5 or 6 years. Then another section, connectivity technology. Okay. So just gave it a heading, because in 2019, UPSC asked about 4G. In 2019, UPSC asked about 4G. Okay. See, all your doubts and queries, I'll take it at the end of the session. Okay, I'll discuss all your doubts and queries at the end of this session. Now listen, okay. Please spare your doubts for the end of the session. So 2019, UPSC asked about 4G. Because 4G was a hot topic in 2018 and 2019. So what connectivity technology you can expect in 2020? Can you suggest me? What mobile communication technology you can expect? If they used to ask a mobile communication technology, what would they ask? Yes, 5G would be the next one. Okay, 5G would be the next one. So you can expect a question from 5G, or we can expect a question from 5G. If they decide to ask a question from 5G, you can expect a question. Getting it? So 5G is a hot topic for 2020's prelims, and please make sure that you're familiar with these terms: millimeter waves, small cells, MIMO technology, duplex technology, beam forming. Okay, so only make sure that if you hear these terms, if you see these terms in your question paper, please make sure that it is associated with 5G. Okay, if you see these kind of terms, beam forming, millimeter waves, these two terms are highly important. Millimeter waves and beam forming, these are highly important. If you see these two terms in your question paper, please make sure that you're associating those terms with 5G. Okay, mechanism you can study it yourself, but only understand that if these terminologies are there in your question paper, these terms are associated with 5G. Getting it? So these are some of the technology that will prime move 5G. Okay, 5G is based on these kind of technologies. Okay, then you should study about advantage of 5G over previous generation of networks. Okay, three features of fifth generation networks over previous generation of mobile networks. Or what is the difference between 5G and 4G? What makes 5G a better technology than 4G? So these kind of differences and comparisons you should follow. Getting it? Along with these terms. And there are many other current affairs related to 5G news, such as, is there any specific committee which was set up to find a roadmap regarding 5G? Is there any specific committee, government committee, set up for studying the compatibility of 5G or creating a roadmap for 5G in India? Good, very good. So there is an AK Paul Raj committee is there in news. It was in news. This particular committee is associated with 5G, creation of roadmap to the 5G network. So please remember that you are learning these kind of committee name, current affairs which comes in news associated with 5G. Getting it? So this is another topic. All clear? All clear? So once again, I'm reminding you, this is all content rich topics. Okay, it won't be able to teach this content in a 2-hour session. So make sure that you're following all these contents for your upcoming prelims. Getting it? And one more thing, for some of the topics, we'll be giving you handouts. Okay, we'll be sharing you some materials for some of the topics, because it won't be easier for you to get all those informations from websites. So we have compiled some of the important topics. Okay, that we'll share you with the Island IAS Telegram channel. So make sure that you are subscribed to the Telegram channel. Getting it? So others, you have to prepare it by yourself. So that is it. The next one, just like 5G, there is another technology. let me stop the share again, stop the screen sharing again. I'll reconnect it. Yes, this is another technology you can expect a question. In 2018, UPSC asked about Internet of Things. Internet of Things. So this was a very lengthy question. Okay, aspirants had to read all these paragraphs in order to find the answer. There is something called Internet of Things. Now, there is something known as Internet of Everything. Okay, so Internet of Thing is a past thing. Okay, it's actually evolved. Now, Internet of Everything is the future technology. Internet of Thing is a part of Internet of Everything. So make sure that you are studying about Internet of Everything. Okay, so if you want a summary, I can tell that Internet of Things just connected physical objects. Okay, Internet of Things just connected physical objects. But Internet of Everything, it connects people, physical objects, data, and all the ideas. Okay, so this is a broader term. In more simpler terms, Internet of Everything means people or public, data, physical things, everything is connected to each other, not just the things, not just the smart devices which we used to know. Okay, so Internet of Thing is a subset of Internet of Everything. Make sure that you are getting the basic understanding of Internet of Everything. Internet of Everything. Getting it? So Internet of Everything. See, it is not possible to provide a YouTube video because the state is actually, the capital is actually what got into containment zone. So it won't be possible to go there and shoot the video. That is why YouTube video won't be available. Okay, because of this pandemic, our institution is actually within the containment zone. That is why there won't be any YouTube video. Okay, so make sure that you are studying Internet of Everything. This would be an important area for this year's prelims. Getting it? And if it possible, study these two things also. Internet Protocol and Virtual Private Network. This is two interesting topic which UPSC can frame questions on. Internet Protocol and Virtual Private Networks, because everyone is using VPN. Okay, so make sure that you are studying VPN and Internet Protocol. So this particular question contains four different options, and three of them are highly important: Internet of Things, Internet Protocol, Virtual Private Network. Getting it? So this VPN and Internet Protocol is important. So please make sure that you are studying this. Then, hope it's clear, right? Hope this is clear. Then let me move into the next one. See, I'm facing some difficulties in sharing questions. I mean, sharing the screen. So I need to stop screen sharing. I'll be reconnected again. Okay. So this one, emerging technology. Another area, emerging technology. Emerging technology. So technologies like 3D printing, technologies like Bitcoin, and technologies like cyber attacks and digital India questions, and topics like Project Loon. All these are questions based on current affair. Strictly based on current affairs. All these are questions strictly based on current affairs. Okay. So there is nothing we can do in it. If you know about science and technology thing that came in current affair, you can solve these questions. Okay. So Project Loon, WannaCry, then topics like Bitcoins, all these are current affair related topics. So make sure that science and technology is very much what focused on current affairs. So you are reading all those current affairs related topics. Getting it? And let me give you one such a trick. If you want to know a trick, there is a, this is this can be called as a trick. 3D printing has applications in which of the following? Okay. In fact, most of you have seen many memes related to what? Technology-based question or application-based questions in science and technology. What would be the answer if UPSC asks a question regarding application of a particular technology? What would be your answer? What would be your answer? Are you getting my question? Yes, UPSC may be asking like, what would be the application of a particular technology? That can be a question. Okay, so irrespective of the technology, UPSC can ask a question. What would be the application of this particular technology? Okay, so in 90% of the times, if UPSC asked about application, it would be all of the above. So if you want a pattern, if you want a trend, you can take it. Okay, but make sure that you're going through the options first. Okay, rather than marking B, all of the above as the answer, make sure that you're going through the options. Okay, so this is it, 3D printing and its application. And Bitcoin, if you know about Bitcoin, you can solve it. Okay, if you know that Bitcoin is a decentralized technology, you knew that Bitcoins cannot be tracked because Bitcoins are decentralized. Getting it? So this statement can be avoided, other two statements are correct. So these are all factual questions. If you know the data, you can solve it. Getting it? So focus on current affairs. Focus on current affairs. And current affairs, what we can do is, at the end of this session or by this week or next week, I can give you a list of, say, a top 100 current affairs in science and technology, a list of top 100 science and technology related topics which came in news the last 1 year. That is a maximum we can do because it's not, it won't be possible to teach each of these technologies. So we'll be giving you a list of these kind of terminologies which appeared in news in the past 1 year so that you can focus on those things. Getting it? So I'll be looking into it, providing you a list of current affairs topics. Okay, top science and technology current affairs topic. Getting it? So these are questions based on current affairs. So that's it. We have finished the first session. Some technology related questions we have finished. Okay, are you okay with it? The mode of discussion. Okay, so please understand that there is no any specific patterns or trends. So that is why the section is like this. And it is not possible to teach you things also. So that is why the focus of this session is to giving you direction. Okay, where to focus. Are you getting it? Are you okay with the first session? I mean, first section of this particular discussion. Okay. Okay. Now the second one, energy. Here also, we'll try to find out some area. Here also, we'll try to find out some areas where UPSC love to focus. Okay. So these are four different questions asked in four different years. These are four different questions asked in four different years. So in 1 year, UPSC asked about, in one particular year, UPSC asked about biomass gasification. Biomass gasification, which is used to produce biofuels. Another year, UPSC asked about algae-based biofuels. And another year, UPSC asked about what? Byproducts of sugar industry like bagasse and molasses, which can be used to produce biofuels. And next year also, UPSC asked about some biofuel generation from crops like maize, etc. So in four different years, UPSC focused upon a single topic known as biofuels. It's simply biofuels. So this is an area where you can focus, where you can invest your time in biofuels. Okay, not going to solve questions, but just look at the topic. Biofuel is a favorite topic for UPSC. Okay, so based on the last previous year questions on current affairs, these are the things which I can suggest you. You have to know about the biofuel basics. How biofuels are generated. Okay. What is the difference between aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration? So these kind of things. And what are the microbes which will produce biofuels? Is it only bacterium or fungi or virus? Okay, know these basics, biofuel basics, production of biofuels, know those basics regarding biofuels. It would be important. Then biofuel generation, the word generation means type of biofuel. Okay, there are how many generations of biofuel? How many generations of biofuels are there? Can anybody answer? Biofuel generation, different types of biofuels. Three, only three? Yeah. Yeah, we can tell like there are four different generations of biofuel. First generation biofuel, second generation biofuel, third generation biofuel, fourth generation biofuel. So know the difference between these four generations of biofuel, materials which are used to make these different generations of biofuel. Advantage of a fourth generation biofuel with third generation biofuel and that of third with second generation biofuel. So these kind of comparisons should be known to you. So knowing about biofuel generation and its basic crops used, microbes used, process and methods used. So these kind of things should be known to you. You can expect a question. Getting it? And most importantly, last year in 2019, we expected a question regarding National Biofuel Policy 2018, but they didn't ask. So this year you can expect a question on National Biofuel Policy. So this is an important area, National Biofuel Policy, where you can expect some questions. Okay. And all other current affairs. Okay, I'll try to include the current affairs regarding biofuels in within that list. Okay. So by that time, you have to focus, you have to give your time on these topics. National Biofuel Policy 2018 and its provisions. So this is highly important. Getting it? So this is another area, biofuel. Okay. Then, next one. So this particular question is regarding nuclear energy. This particular slide is regarding nuclear energy. Okay, in three different years, UPSC asked about nuclear energy. First one, the function of heavy water in a nuclear reactor. And second one, what is the prospect of for India if it joins International Thermonuclear Experiment Reactor? Another question was regarding the comparison between thorium and uranium. The comparison between thorium and uranium. In fact, this particular question was the toughest one. It is one of the toughest questions asked by UPSC. Okay, are you able to solve that particular question? Are you able to solve this particular question? Can you give me some answers? What would be the answer of that particular question? Other two are comparatively easier. Other two are comparatively easier. Can you give me the answer regarding the first one? To meet this rapidly growing energy demand, C would be the answer. 1 and 3. A would be the answer. B would be the answer. Somebody says D is the answer. Again, D is the answer. So what would be the correct option? So first one, at least, would you be able to eliminate the first one or try to find out whether the first statement is correct or not? Thorium is far more abundant in nature than uranium. Definitely. First statement is obviously correct. Thorium is 2 or 3 times abundant than uranium. First statement is correct. Then third statement is also correct. Thorium produces less harmful waste compared to uranium, which is again correct. And second one is actually correct. But it is not possible to know these statements as such. On the basis of per unit mass of mined mineral, thorium can generate more energy. Nobody is going to focus on this much, minute things, specific things. It would be, that is why that particular statement makes this question a very difficult one. Getting it? So these kind of questions can be expected in the exam. Better you have a holistic idea about these technologies, then you can take a risk. if you are at a position, you can take a chance. Okay, but look at the area. If you see, I asked about nuclear fuel. So you got an area, nuclear fuel. You can focus on nuclear fuel. And another one, UPSC asked about different international thermonuclear experiment reactor. That is about nuclear fusion. Okay, so UPSC asked about nuclear fission and fusion. So you can expect a question on what you can study on, study the difference between nuclear fission and fusion. Third one, UPSC asked about the function of heavy water. That particular question is regarding the components of a nuclear reactor. So you can focus on the components of nuclear reactor. So these are the areas you should focus: nuclear fuels, nuclear fission and fusion, nuclear reactors and its types and its components and its functions. You have to focus on these things. Okay, so these are the area you can focus on. Getting it? So let me stop the sharing again, because after some day this sharing it get paused. Okay, so based on my suggestions here I suggested to study about nuclear fuel. Here I study the difference between fission and fusion. Here I said what discussed about nuclear reactor. You have to study about nuclear reactor. Then one thing you have to focus is India's three stage nuclear program. This is an important area where you should focus. India's three-stage nuclear program, you have to focus. This is a very important area, and we'll be giving a handout for this particular topic. India's three-stage nuclear program, we'll be giving a handout. Okay, so you have to study stage one, stage two, stage three separately. What makes each stage is different from the previous one? What are the fuel used? What are the reactors used? What are the byproducts? So these kind of things should be known to you. So India's nuclear program, three-stage nuclear program, is very much important, because if you look at this particular program, you can see thorium and uranium here. So you basically can ask a question from here. Then here there are many type of nuclear reactors. So if you study about India's three-stage nuclear program, you will be studying about different type of nuclear reactors. So you can answer a question. Getting it? So that is why this particular program is important. India's three-stage nuclear program, you have to make a note. Okay. Or we'll be giving a handout, you have to study it. This is an important topic. And let me ask you a question. At which stage are we currently in? India has a three-stage nuclear program, and we are at which stage? First stage or second stage? First stage or second stage? Yeah, second stage. Okay. See, for all those things, we'll be giving you handouts. Go through it. It will be sufficient. Getting it? So this was another area. And next one. Shall I move forward? So this is next area. Was nuclear energy clear? So under energy, we discussed about biofuels and nuclear energy. Now this is the third area. So in one particular year, UPSC asked about coal bed methane. Another year, UPSC asked about methane hydrate. Then another year, UPSC asked about shale gas. And what can we call these resources? What are these coal bed methane? What is this shale gas? Or what is this methane hydrate? There is a collective name for this. Alternative energy, no, unconventional, complete it. Fossil, yeah, it's a kind of fossil, but what kind of fossil fuel? It's not renewable. Remember, it's not renewable. Please make sure that you have thorough understanding between which is renewable, which is not renewable. Yeah, these are unconventional gas resources. So make sure that you are studying about these unconventional gas resources and the most important dhamma, shale gas, carbon methane, and methane hydrate. So these three unconventional gas resources which UPSC have already asked questions from each of these areas. But it won't be wise enough to leave these area. We have to focus again on these areas because there is no other thing. Okay, so these unconventional gas resources area, you have to focus. You can expect a question from this. Getting it? And look at the nature of question asked. Can you solve the first question regarding carbon methane? Carbon methane. Can you explain the first one? I mean, find the answer for the first one. Carbon methane. What would be the answer? Rather than solving it using your knowledge, solve it using your what? The technology we have or the tricks we have given in the Theropolis introductory section. Rather than solving it using your knowledge, solve it using your what? That Theropolis directive keywords which we have given to you. Everyone is saying D. Very good. Okay. So why D? Carbon methane is pure methane gas extracted from coal seams, while shale gas is a mixture of propane and butane only. Okay, only is a rotten tomato. Shale is basically methane. Okay, so first statement is not correct because of a rotten tomato. Then second one, in India, abundant carbon methane resources exist, but so far no shale gas resources have been found, which is again a wrong one. In India, there are many potential shale gas resources, and we have identified many shale gas resources in India. So both the statements are kind of extreme statements. So this would be the nature of questions. So look at the relationship between question. One year, they asked like there is no shale gas reserve, and in another year, they asked like where we can find shale gas reserves in India. Okay, so they have connected the topics. So that is why analyzing previous year questions are highly important. Getting it? So anyway, you have to study these unconventional gas resources. Okay, shale, carbon methane, methane hydrate, and this one, tight gas. Tight gas is nothing but methane entrapped in a rock. A pocket of rock, which is not easier to extract. So look at this figure. This particular gas, this particular methane is entrapped within a pocket of rock, which is not easy to extract. Getting it? So that is what a tight gas, some fancy name. So you have to focus on these unconventional gas resources and current affairs also. Do not forget about current affairs. Getting it? So please pair your doubts at the end of the session. Okay, I'll be clearing all those doubts at the end of your sessions. Okay, then next. So this is one such important area. Then, just like fossil fuel, UPSC can also ask questions regarding questions from renewable energy. Okay, so in one particular year, UPSC asked about solar energy. Other 2 years, UPSC asked about fuel cells. So these are some technology related renewable energy topics. Okay, photovoltaic technology, fuel cell technology. Okay, they are not just asking what renewable energy as such. They are connecting a technology with renewable energy. Okay, UPSC know that, or we know that hydrogen contains energy. So harnessing energy from hydrogen is because of a particular technology, that is fuel cell technology. And just like that, UPSC know that solar energy, sun has some energy, and to harness that energy from sun, we should need a technology, that is photovoltaic technology. So just like that, connect this renewable energy with the technology used to extract them. Getting it? So focus on renewable energy. You'll be getting a question literally every year from renewable energy. And this year, give your focus on wind energy. Give your focus on wind energy. Because UPSC haven't asked wind that much. Okay, but wind energy, India is actually cruising what in the production of wind energy year by year. So there is a very high chance that a question regarding wind energy, production of wind energy, statics related to wind energy, technology used to harness wind energy, just like offshore wind energy turbines. So just like offshore wind energy turbines. Offshore wind energy turbines. Okay, so these kind of technologies should be known to you. Getting it? So this is a highly, what, a hot topic for 2020 prelims. Wind energy. You can expect a question from wind energy. And make sure that you are studying the technology associated with it. Getting it? So this is renewable energy for you. Clear? All clear for you? All clear for you? So we have covered energy. Under energy, we have covered biofuels, nuclear energy, then renewable energy. We have identified some areas where we should focus. Clear? Nobody is responding. Okay. Okay. Great, great, great. So this is one such area you have to focus. Now, moving into next biotechnology. Moving to next biotechnology. Another area which UPSC asks a plenty of questions. Biotechnology is an area in which UPSC asks plenty of questions. Let me show you five different questions asked in five different years. The first topic. In one particular year, UPSC asked about GM mustard. Another year, UPSC asked about BT brinjal. Then, very next year, UPSC again asked about BT brinjal. Another year, UPSC asked about genetically modified or genetically engineered plants. And another year, UPSC again asked about technologies which are used to create transgenic crops. See, five different years, five different questions based on which topic? Genetically modified crops. So this is a very hot topic, a very favorite topic for UPSC. Genetically modified crops in India, especially in India. Okay, so please make sure that you are investing a good time in studying about GM crops. And not just facts, it's overall analysis. Okay, so mugging up all the facts related to GM crops won't be helping in your health exam. Because UPSC can ask you about analytical question. So like, look at this first question. Look at this, this mark question. Other than resistance to pest, what are the prospects for which GM crops are created? So here UPSC asked about the advantage of GM crops. Okay, advantage of GM crops. Then here, look at this question. What are the reasons for the people's resistance to the introduction of BT brinjal? Here UPSC asked about the challenges of BT crops, right? So here UPSC asked about the advantage of GM crops. Here UPSC asked about the challenges raised by GM crops. And all other questions were factual. Okay, so here again, advantages. So when you study GM crops, you should have an overall understanding. What are GM crops? Why do we need GM crops? What are the challenges offered by GM crops? And what are the solutions? And what are the authorities? What are the regulations, rules and regulations that exist in India, which will prevent the negative impacts of GM crops in India? So these kind of overall analysis should be done by you. Okay, and obviously some facts. Obviously some facts. Getting it? So GM crops is a very important area for UPSC prelims as well as in your mains. As well as in your mains. So make sure that you are studying GM crops in both prelims perspective as well as in mains perspective. This is highly important. Getting it? So GM crops, this is highly important. And for just solving sake of solving a question, can you solve this question? All other questions you can solve. You can solve all other questions, but can you solve this particular question? And all other questions require some kind of facts also. That's why I chose this question. This doesn't need any fact. Consider the following techniques. Which of the above is or are used to create transgenic crops? Transgenic crops. Give me your answers. Okay, B, C. Many B and C's. Many B and C's, okay. B, okay, most of you have gone with B. And answer is B. Very much answer is B. Why? See, budding and grafting in fruit plants, we have been doing it for a very long time, right? And if budding and grafting is used in creating transgenic crops, will we allow it? No. Budding and grafting is a very common practice, which won't be creating any transgenic crops. We should be creating some hybrid crops. Hybrid crops are not transgenic crops. Now the difference between hybrid crops and transgenic crops. Not all the hybrid crops are transgenic crops. Okay, budding and grafting are used to create hybrid crops, not transgenic crops. Okay, so one can be eliminated. Now two and three, none. And it is very much know that gene silencing is one of the such methods used to create transgenic crops. So answer is B, two and three. So it's an easier question. Okay, two and three is the answer. Getting it? So that's it. That is regarding GM crops. Okay, that is regarding GM crops. Let me share the session again. Okay. Then, moving on. So this is it. So these are the types you have to study. Overall analysis of GM crops and different GM crops that presently there in India, the regulations of GM crops in India. And let me ask you some questions. What are the GM crops in India, which are currently in news? Can you give me some names of GM crops, which actually there in India, and which is there in news for the past 1 year? BT cotton is there. Yes, BT cotton, more. BT cotton is there. BT brinjal is there. Then mustard is there. Genetically modified mustard is there. And what is the name of that mustard? What is the name of that mustard variety? DMH, Dara mustard hybrid. Okay, yeah, DMH 11. So you should know about these GM crops which actually exist in India. And can you give me any regulatory authorities in India which is there for GM crops? Yes, GEAC is there. GEAC is there. And GEAC was established under which law? Remember about the environment module which we have discussed. GEAC was established under, yes, exactly, Environment Protection Act 1986. Okay, so these kind of information should be known to you. Getting it? And role of biosafety clearing house. Role of biosafety clearing house. There is a biosafety clearing house in India. So these kind of regulatory authorities and rules should be known to you. Okay, you can expect a question. Clear about GM crops? Okay about GM crops? Yes. Okay, so focus on these areas. Okay, next, another area which UPSC loves very much. Okay, literally every year there will be a question from this area, which is genetic engineering, which demands and then some serious content. Unless we are having some good content in this particular topic, we won't be able to solve this. It's very difficult to solve these kind of questions from genetic engineering unless we are having some solid content. Okay. So recombinant DNA technology, transcriptomes, Cas9 proteins, then genome sequencing, then again DNA sequencing, RNA interference, all these are genetic engineering related terminologies which appears in news every year. So we should know that this demands some certain kind of content. Okay, if you don't have enough content, it is not possible to solve these kind of questions. So for making your preparation easier, I'll be giving a handout which contains the genetic engineering basics. We'll be giving a handout which contains the genetic engineering basics, terminologies and technologies under genetic engineering in a general perspective. Okay, we'll be explaining all the fundamental terms and terminologies related to genetic engineering, and we'll be sharing a handout with you. Student, you don't have to prepare a specific separate handout for it. We'll be giving a handout for you. So genetic engineering basics. So this is highly important. Getting it? So unless and until you are having what specific sound solid content in genetic engineering, we won't be able to solve these kind of questions. So we'll be giving you handouts. Getting it? So that is it, genetic engineering basics. Okay. So in order to solve this question, you should need some basic content. Okay. So that's it. That is regarding genetic engineering. So please remember that you are studying genetic engineering. And 12th standard biology, plus 2 biology is an important source material where you can depend on. There is something called biotechnology. Okay, biotechnology and genetic engineering, there is some chapters regarding it. Okay, so 12th standard biology textbook would be an useful resource material for you if you want to use it as a basic source. 12th standard biology textbook, NCERT textbook would be enough. Okay, so meanwhile you go through this 12th standard biology textbook, and when we give you that handout, go through it. It will contain some basics. All clear? Genetic engineering? Okay, have you identified 2 areas in biotechnology where UPSC will pick up questions? First one is GM props. Second one is genetic engineering. So these are the 2 areas where UPSC will focus. Clear? All clear. Shall I move forward? Genetic engineering and GM crops. Okay. Then next one, look at these questions. Look at this question. Here UPSC asked about biotoilets. In one particular year, UPSC asked about biotoilet, basically decomposition. Another year, UPSC asked about bioremediation. Basically decomposition. Okay, so UPSC asked about bioremediation, UPSC asked about decomposition. Here UPSC asked about biopesticides. Okay, which of the above organisms can be used as biopesticides? And here UPSC asked about biofertilizers. So there are many words which can be, or many technologies are there in biotechnology, like biofertilizer, biopesticides, biosensors, then bioremediation. So these kind of technologies are there in biotechnology. So make sure that you are studying these topics itself. So these questions are your best reference material. Okay, so please follow this chart. You should make your own notes. We won't be giving any handouts on this particular topic. Rather, you should make your own notes regarding biofertilizer, biopesticides, bioremediation, and bioeffectors. So bioeffectors more or less similar to biofertilizer. Make sure that you are making your own notes on these topics: biofertilizer, biopesticides, bioremediation, and bioeffectors. So this is highly important. Make sure that you are making your notes based on these keywords. Prepare on these keywords. We'll be getting any questions in any different year. Getting it? So this is highly important. And can you solve the first question regarding biotoilets? Can you solve the first question regarding biotoilets? Can you give me the answer? First one, the decomposition of human waste in the biotoilet is initiated by a fungal inoculum. Second one, ammonia and water vapor are the only end products in this decomposition. Is A is the answer? Why A? Answer is not A. Answer is D. Answer is D. Decomposition is not by fungus but by bacteria. Okay. So please do remember the basics. Decomposition is not by fungus but by bacteria mainly, especially in biotoilets. And ammonia and water products are not the only byproducts. There are many other products. In fact, ammonia is not a product. There can be some traces of ammonia, but ammonia is not a major product. Carbon dioxide can be a major byproduct. Please do remember the basics. And here, the answer is D. Then bioremediation. What is the answer of the 14th one? Bioremediation. What would be your answer? What would be your answer? At least eliminate one single option. Eliminate a statement. If you want to eliminate a statement, which statement you'd eliminate? 14th one. If you want to eliminate a statement, which statement you'd eliminate? Yes, good, good. See, second statement can be eliminated, right? Any contaminant with heavy metals will be treated completely and readily by these microbes. See, so much rotten tomatoes. Okay, completely, readily, any contaminant. Okay, three rotten tomatoes in a single statement. So two can be eliminated. Answer would be C. Getting it? So these are some of the questions you can use. Okay. So this is it. Okay. So please do remember about the areas where you should focus in biotechnology. First one was GM crops. Second one was, what was second one? After GM crops, we finished what? See, I lost the connection. What was it? Yeah, genetic engineering. Basics of genetic engineering. Genetic engineering was another thing. Then third one, these words made using bio prefix. Biofertilizer, biopesticides, bioremediation, etc. Bio words, bio-related words. So make sure that you are preparing your own notes regarding GM crops and these bio-related words. We'll be giving you handouts regarding genetic engineering technologies because it's a bit hard to make notes. So we'll be giving handouts in genetic engineering related technology. Other two sections you have to make notes. Getting it? So this is another thing. Got it? Shall I move forward? Biotechnology is over. Okay. So let me move on. So this is space technology. Next one is space technology. Okay, so space technology, the questions will be largely based on current affairs. Okay, some mission related questions would be there. The current affairs related things would be there. So questions will be mostly based on current affairs. So if you check the questions, see, this question was regarding space missions. This one is regarding, again, space mission by IRNSS. This one is again space mission, AstroSat. A mission by ISRO. Again, another mission, ELISA. Another mission, Then I think I lost the screen sharing. I'll be sharing it again. Okay. Yes. Yes, the sharing has. Okay, this question was regarding Elisa. And again, this one regarding Mangalyaan. Mangalyaan. See, so questions are there based on missions by different space organizations, space agencies, by ISRO, by NASA, by European Space Agency. So this is one such kind of questions. Questions are based on current affairs. Okay. So where to get information, where to get what solid information regarding these missions, it's better to visit the official websites. Okay, it's better to visit the official website. So we have, you have to focus on ISRO, NASA, and then as an addition, European Space Agency. ESA is not that much advisable, but ISRO, NASA, these two websites, you should be what? Visiting it. So SpaceX, all those are private missions which are there in current affair, that you'll get in current affair material. But these three space agencies, you'll be referring these official websites of these space missions regularly, or at least to get information. See, let me show you. See, this is the official website of ISRO. Okay. See, if you visit the official website of ISRO, you can see that there are some programs within their homepage itself. You can expect questions from there. Look at it. Yuvika 2020 is postponed. So you can expect a question. What is Yuvika? So that can be a current affair. Then there are other missions. MOM is there. NAVIC is there. Okay, you can see MOM is there. NAVIC or IRNSS is there. So you can get information from the official website itself. And along with that, you can use this tab. You can use this tab, mission tab. You can use it. Mission. Okay. See, if you go through mission, you can see that some trending missions are there. Some latest missions are there. And if there is any future mission, you can refer that also. Getting it? So look at it. Some trending missions. CARE mission is there. AstroSat is there. Mars orbit mission is there. Then as a latest mission, GSAT 30 is there. So you have to focus on this current affairs. Getting it? So this should be your reference material. Then if you go through spacecraft, let me take the spacecraft. See, there are plenty of different type of spacecraft. Communication satellites, Earth observation satellites. Okay, so you can see spacecrafts there. You can see rocket launchers there. Operational launchers are there. Historic launchers, you don't need to refer it again. But operational launchers are there, and under which GSLV MK3 is highly important. Please do remember that you are focusing on GSLV MK3. GSLV Mark 3 is important. And future missions are there. RLV-TD is there. What is RLV-TD? RLV-TD is there. What is RLV-TD? Can you give me any full form? RLV-TD, what is RLV-TD? Yeah, reusable launch vehicle, exactly. Reusable launch vehicle. So you can refer these things. Getting it? So this is how you have to use the website of ISRO. The website of ISRO. Getting it? Then, let me show you the website of other thing. The NASA is there. If you visit NASA, you can see again. So let it load. Okay, if you visit the official website of NASA, you can see many current affairs. All those current affairs which you have read in your different current affairs material. Tap the mission tab. So there is a mission tab. Look at the programs, name of program there. Artemis program is there. Hubble Space Telescope is there. James Webb Space Telescope is there. Juno mission is there. InSight mission, ISS, New Horizons, all these missions are there. So this is a favorite area where UPSC will pick up questions. Getting it? getting it? So in fact, among these lists, the Artemis program is highly important. James Webb Space Telescope is highly important. Okay, then so these are the Parker Solar Probe is also important. Parker Solar Probe is also important. Artemis, James Webb, Parker Solar Probe. So these were the programs which was there in news. Okay. So this is it. If you visit NASA website, you can see these things. Got it? Getting it? So make sure that you are visiting the official websites of ISRO and NASA and get information from there. Get information from there. Okay. Okay with it. The first topic. Current affairs related things, way to get information. Okay. So that's it. Okay, this is another area you should focus. Getting it? Then, so these kind of questions can be solved if you have gone through those two websites. So European Space Agency is just an addition. If you want to visit it, you can visit it. That's simply an addition. Okay. And another thing, this one, make sure that you are studying these things very thoroughly. Different type of satellite orbits. Different type of satellite orbits. Make sure that you are studying the basics of satellite orbits. What makes a low Earth orbit different from a geostationary Earth orbit? Okay. What makes a low Earth orbit satellite different from a geostationary Earth orbit satellites? Make sure that you are studying the difference between these two orbits. Because if you have orbits, you'll be able to identify the application of satellite in that particular orbit. The kind of launchers we use, to launch a satellite into that particular orbit. The technical requirements of launchers used to launch these kind of satellites into that particular orbit. Okay, so these kind of information would be getting to you. So it is highly important that you are studying the difference between the low Earth orbit satellites and geostationary Earth orbit satellites. Okay, because UPSC used to ask questions regarding satellites, application of satellites. Okay, if UPSC ask a question regarding what are the application of a particular satellite, you should be able to understand whether it is a communication satellite or a remote sensing satellite. If you are able to identify it as a communication satellite or a remote sensing satellite, you'll be able to what? Identify the part or application of that particular satellite. So that is why studying about these two orbits are important. So make sure that you are studying these orbits. You're studying about these orbits. Okay. So again, I'm telling you, it's not possible to teach you the difference between these orbits here itself. It will be a bit time consuming. So make sure that you are studying it here on. Okay. So from YouTube or from any other material, there are plenty of materials that are available which explains the difference between these two orbits. So connect with orbit, connect orbit, satellite and launchers. Connect orbits, satellites and launcher. So you'll be getting a series of questions here. All clear? All clear. So let me show you some questions. Here, UPSC asked about the application of remote sensing satellite. Here also UPSC asked about remote sensing satellite. Here also UPSC asked about a geostationary orbit. Third one, UPSC asked about a geostationary orbit. If and only if you know that a geostationary orbit is not at a distance of 22,000 kilometer. Okay. So at what altitude it is? Can anyone tell? The orbit is at an altitude of 22,000 kilometer. Is it correct? Geostationary orbit. What is the altitude of geostationary orbit? Yes, yeah, roughly around 36,000. It's roughly around 36,000. Get. So if and only if you know the fact, you can solve this question. So it is very important that you are studying about the connection between satellite orbit, satellite, different type of satellite in a particular orbit, and different type of launchers we use to launch a particular satellite, because all are interconnected. All are interconnected. Make sure that you are studying it. Make sure that you are studying it. Getting it? See, all these are related to orbits and satellites. All these are questions related to orbits and satellites. And can you solve the 95th one? Can you guys solve the 95th one? If you have some basic understanding regarding satellites and orbits, you can solve this one. 95th one. What is it? What is your answer? Give me your answer. AC. Okay, most of you are going with A. Okay. So answer is A. So look at the second option. Look at the second options. Satellites launched by PSLV appear to remain permanently fixed in the same position in the sky as viewed from a particular location on Earth, which is wrong. If you know the basics of orbits, if you know the basics of satellites launched using PSLV, you know that PSLVs are of low altitude satellites and it is not fixed, it is continuously moving. Two is actually, it too can be eliminated, which is very basics. And one only, three only, one only is the correct answer. This is very basics, but if you don't have the basics, you cannot solve it. So that is why knowing the basics is highly important. So know the basics. Getting it? And in this option also, UPSC asked about GSLV MK3. And please expect a question on GSLV MK3. You can expect a question. GSLV MK3. This is highly important. This particular portion is highly important. Please make sure that you are studying about GSLV MK3. Got it. Shall I move forward? Okay. So space technology. Two kind of questions in space technology. One is regarding current affair. Other one is regarding the basics. And in fact, some hard questions can be asked. And these three are in that category. From space, very hard question can be asked. Okay. Goldilocks zone. Questions regarding gravity. And questions like this, black holes. So these kind of questions can be asked. So this is very tough. If you have a knowledge in it, go for it. Otherwise, better to leave it, these kind of questions. Because Goldilocks zone, when the aspirants, if a person is not knowing anything about space, Goldilocks zone is completely Greek. It's completely different to it. So this is very hard. So if you have the courage to go for this question, go for it. Otherwise, leave it. And one more thing, if you need a trend, if you need a pattern in this question, so look at the second question. Light is affected by gravity. Universe is constantly expanding. Matter warps its surrounding space-time. So these are very gray areas. Even the scientists are not what having a concurrent view on this particular thing. So this is very gray area. And if any such too technical, too gray areas. Okay, rather than technical, it is very gray. It is not possible to give a confined answer to this particular question, these kind of questions. So better these kind of questions, since it's argument creating one, better to go with all of the above. Okay, so these kind of questions, if such a question which is too gray, too confusing, go with all of the above options. And its answer is 1, 2, and 3. getting it. So if you have the options, if you are at a position to go for it, go for it. Okay, otherwise better to leave these kind of questions. If you are too flexible, if you are too free to choose any question, okay, if you will be what? You should be on the other end. Okay, you are way above the cutoff. You can go with these kind of questions. Getting it. So that is it. Second one, all of the above. So better leave these kind of questions for most of the people. So shall I move forward? Next is defense technology. Defense technology. Okay. So was space clear? We discussed about some utility technology. We discussed about energy. We discussed about biotechnology. And we discussed about space. And we identified many areas where you should focus. And I've given you some suggestions where you should focus for this particular year's prelims. And some source materials and source websites where you can depend on. So these kind of things you should focus. Clear? Clear. Am I clear to you? Okay. Okay. Then defense technology. You don't need to worry about defense technology because only a few questions have been asked in the last 9 years. Very few. Very few questions were asked in the last 9 years. And questions were based on purely based on current affairs. Questions were purely based on current affairs. So one who read the current affairs material can solve these questions because it was that much evident. INS Astadharani was news in 2016. Agni 4, which was what? A missile which was there in news in that particular year. Then terminal high altitude system. Again, a term which appeared in news in 2017. Then this is regarding a very general question. Very general question, you can leave this question, but all other questions are regarding current affairs. All other questions are regarding current affairs. Getting it? And if you want to focus a specific area, if you want to focus some basics, focus on India's guided missile development program. Focus on this particular area. India's guided missile development program. Focus on this area. Okay, the missiles developed under this program, feature of those different missiles. How many missiles were developed under IGMDP? How many missiles were developed under IGMDP? Can you give an answer? Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. Yes, 5 missiles were there. Exactly, 5 missiles were there. So if you want to focus a theoretical portion, focus on this IGMDP. Okay. And also focus on Agni 5. Agni 5, focus on this particular missile. You can expect a question. Agni 5. Okay, Agni 5. So this is highly important. Agni 5 is highly important. Just go through it. Agni 5 can be expected this year. So this is regarding defense technology, only current affairs. Getting it? I hope it's clear. If you read current affairs, you'll be getting questions if they ask. And questions will be basically what? Very current affairs oriented, very what? Simple one. And let me move to the next session. Let me move to the next session. This is regarding NBT. This is regarding NBT or nuclear supplies group. Again, if you know the basics about nuclear supplies group, you can solve it. Okay. And we don't need to visit any official website news, but study on these things. Study on these things. Multilateral export control regimes. Multilateral export control regimes, you should focus. You should give focus on multilateral export control regimes. The nuclear supplies group, missile technology control regime, Wassenaar arrangement, Australia group. So these are the area you should give focus on. Nuclear supplies group, missile technology control regime, Wassenaar arrangement, the Australia group. So you should have a basic understanding regarding the working of these multilateral export control regimes, the nature of membership, the nature of the organization, whether it is intergovernmental or whether it is unofficial, informal groupings, whether India is a member or not. So these kind of basics should be known to you. Multilateral export control regimes. So study it. Getting it? So this is another area you can give focus. Getting it? So that finishes defense technology. I hope it's clear. Shall I move forward? Okay. Then the last one, next session, basic and daily science. And you don't need to worry about these basics and daily science. So this is one such area where people worry about. We are not from science background, and even people from science background find it difficult to answer these questions. But you don't need to worry about these basic science questions, because UPSC only asked basic science related questions till 2013. And after 2013, there was not a single question from basic science. I'll show you the nature of questions from basic science. It is very tough. Okay. So people who are not familiar with the basic science will find it difficult to answer these questions. Okay. So some of them can be solved using a daily life experience. Some of them can be solved using your what? Reading NCERTs, but overall it's quite different, quite difficult, right? Basic science and daily science. So, but fortunately for us, after 2013, UPSC hasn't asked a single question from basic science. And they ask questions purely from NCERT. From class 6 to 10 NCERT, they ask questions based on basic science. After 2013, the kind of questions which you saw in the earlier sessions, kind of application level questions, were the focus one. Getting it? So we'll be giving some important basic science from NCERT as a study material. You only focus on that thing. Getting it? So what I'm planning to give you, a basic science which will be asked by UPSC from NCERT, I'll be giving it to you as a handout. You focus, you read on that handout only. If you are lucky enough, if they decide to ask a question from basic science, if we are lucky enough, we'll be getting a question from that handout. Otherwise, if we are not going to do it, nobody is going to do it. That should be the belief. Because a serious aspirant who puts some serious effort in science and technology, if he or she is not able to do it, please do believe that none is going to do it. That should be your mentality. So this is basic science. Questions are from NCERT. Getting it? And these are some of the questions. So if you see, you can see the nature of questions. I'm not going to solve any of the questions here. I'm only explaining you the nature of questions. See, elements responsible for origin of life, vitamin deficiency diseases, and what is the use of a refrigerator? Then why should we take in antioxidants very much, or vegetables very much? And the question is regarding vegetative propagation of plants. And question is regarding some diseases. And this is from current affair. And again, question regarding diseases. Okay, eradicated diseases, then diseases which can be transmitted from one person to another patient, then contraction of muscles, elements needed, then use of refrigerator again. So actually, this is repeated. Then photosynthesis, science behind photosynthesis, science of trans fat, science of stem cells. So these are all biology basic science questions. Look at the nature of questions. It is not humanly possible for an aspirant to cover these topics by their own. Because from class 6 to class 10, you have to read those all NCERT, science and technology, basic science NCERT. And even though if you read those NCERT, we'll be get confused where to focus. So that is the problem of this area. But fortunately, as I told you earlier, UPSC haven't picked up any questions from basic science post 2013. questions were purely technical, questions were purely what? Analytical in nature, application level in nature. So you don't need to worry about these technical, what, basic science things if you haven't studied it. But those who are planning to study, we'll be giving a study material, some basic study material, science in daily life. You go through it. If you're lucky, we'll be getting questions from it. Otherwise, leave it. Nothing more to do in it. Getting it? Are you able to hear me? Are you okay? Are you okay with this explanation? Clear. So this is why everyone hates science and technology. And those people who have studied science and technology in their graduation, they find it difficult to answer question, because this is it. This is the nature of this particular subject. Getting it? And from physics, look at the question asked in physics. Water purification system. Process involving what? Water, the slide is stuck again. Let me share it again. Okay, please wait. Okay. See, look at the questions from physics and chemistry. So process of UV radiation in water purification system, use of ball bearings in bicycles, then optical illusions, then phenomena of capillarity, then ball bearings again, a repeated one, then non-forces of nature, for mixture of water. So these are all basis questions. Difference between CFL and LED, all these are basis questions. Okay, rare earth minerals, these are all basic questions. So don't need to worry about these questions. These are all old questions for beyond what? Prior to 2013. And let me show you some questions. Just check whether you can solve these questions or not. Okay, and this is an important topic this year. Water purifiers, this is important. Please make sure that you're studying about water purifiers, because some news was there in last 1 year regarding water purifiers, right? If I'm not wrong, a news regarding water fuel, some regulation or some technical change was there in news with regarding to water purifier systems. Reverse osmosis, I think it is the news. It was the news. So please do remember that this water purifier systems. Yeah, that's it. Go through it. And this particular one, rare earth minerals. This year, it takes some, what? It has some importance, rare earth minerals. Okay, so give importance to rare earth minerals also. Because rare earth minerals was also there in news. Okay. So one second, let me stop the sharing, because I need to power up my computer. So please wait online, okay? So welcome back again. Sorry for the interruption. Okay. So are you able to hear me? Can you hear me? Okay. So that's it. So let me share the screen again. Just check some of the questions I'll be showing to you, whether you can solve it or not. Okay. So focus on rare earth minerals and water purifier for this year's prelims. You can expect a question from either of these two topics. And let me show you some questions. Okay. So can you do the capillarity question? Phenomena of capillarity questions. Can you solve it using your logic, not based on your science knowledge, but based on your knowledge, common sense? If there were no phenomena of capillarity, what would be the answer? All of the above. It's a 1, 2, 3, 4. See, there are no options. But first one, it would be difficult to use a kerosene lamp. Okay. So let me explain it. Okay. Since there are no options, it will be difficult for you to say an answer. Okay. This actually 1, 2, 3, 4 question, right? So let me check it. If there are no phenomena of capillarity, what would be the effects? You know what is capillarity, right? Capillarity means what? So the rise of a liquid, a water through some small, minute, what? Cylinder. Okay. So it would be difficult to use a kerosene lamp. Yes. Because if kerosene need to, what? Go up, the phenomenon of capillarity should be there. Then third one, the blotting paper would fail to function. Yes. The blotting paper should suck up all the ink or all the liquid from the particular surface, it need capillarity. Then if trees need to grow, they need to absorb water. So roots should have a capillarity mechanism. So 1, 3, 4 are correct statements. And what about second statement? What makes second statement wrong? One would not be able to use a straw to consume a soft drink. Is it because of capillarity? No, it's not because of capillarity, but we have to suck it. We have to use the what? Vacuum application of no pressure there. Okay. We have to pull up a soft drink using a straw. It's not because of capillarity. Capillarity is a natural process. Okay. Capillarity, we are purposefully doing it. What? Consuming a soft drink. But all other options are happening naturally without any external force. Okay. So without any external force, all other three happens, but not the second one. So that is how we have to solve this. Getting it? And this is an area you should focus, right? Optical phenomena you should focus. Okay, so let me share the screen again. Okay, so are you able to see this? See, these optical illusions or optical phenomena, you should focus. Okay. See, these processes like refraction, reflection, total internal reflection, diffraction. So we'll be getting a handout. Don't worry, we'll be getting a handout. So these kind of optical illusions, optical phenomena should be known to you. So this is another good area where you can invest your time. Getting it? So that's it. That is another important area. Then that's it. Then the final section, nanotechnology. Only two questions have been asked till 2019. And that two questions were applications of nanotechnology. So this is regarding graphene. So graphene is a hot topic. Everyone is knowing about graphene. And second one is regarding application. So what would be the answer of second question? without even looking into the question, can you find the answer of second one? Applications of nanotechnology, what would be it? Yes, both one and two, but make sure that you read options here. Answer is both one and two, but not all the time, maybe. Can you solve the graphene related question? Graphene related question, what is your answer? It is entirely made of silicon and it has high optical transparency. Is graphene entirely made of silicon? Third option. No, third one is wrong. C is the correct answer. Again, C is the correct answer. Graphene is made of carbon, not actually graphene. Not actually silicon. Okay. So that finishes our session. Okay. So that finishes the number of sessions, different sections in science and technology. Getting it? So let me sum the entire session again. So first we discussed about some public utility technologies bought by government and some emerging technologies, and you got a resource or a specific website you can use by yourself. Then we focused upon energy, and where we found out that you have to focus on renewable energy, you have to focus on nuclear energy, and you have to give focus on biofuels also. And I have given you some suggestions where you should focus. And definitely in biotechnology, next session was biotechnology, where three things we studied: genetically modified crops, genetic engineering, then last that bio-related keywords. And among these three, I'll be giving you the handout of genetic engineering related technology. Then later in nanotechnology, in defense technology, in space, we have seen some important topics where you should give focus. And for those students, who are taking IELTS test series. Okay. So I'll be telling you that in that science and technology test series, we had a science and technology full test there. Then following it, we had a revision test, and after the full test, okay, I think two or three full tests are complete till now. So all these full tests, all those revision tests, and all those entire full length science and technology test series, it contained the most important around 150 topics of the last 1 year till February, till March. Okay, the most important 150 topics till March are there in those test series. In science and technology full length tests and the revision test which came after it, and the all the full length series, comprehensive test series, it contains all the important topics. Okay, so those who attended IELTS science and technology test series, please revise the question paper again, because it contains all the important topics. Getting it? And there will be a test series as a part of this tier of prelims. Okay, just like other topics, there will be a daily test series. Okay, so those who are not part of it, those who are not part of the test series, we can practice it for some 2 or 3 days just after this discussion. Okay, and I'll be giving you some current affairs materials, which I promised to give you in within 1 week or 2 weeks. And any other doubts? Any other doubts? Exactly. Okay. Now it's time to ask your questions. I'll be taking your doubts. Yeah, COVID-19 is important. COVID-19 all happened after April or March, specifically after March. But focus on COVID-19. You can expect a question. Different technologies, different terminologies associated with different technologies and terminologies associated with COVID-19, like that of polymerase chain reaction, PCR technology, what is PPE kit, what is N95 mask. So these kind of questions can be asked. Okay, so these kind of technical terms should be known to you. Okay, you can expect a question from COVID-19. Then PAP source. Okay, one more thing I have to suggest you or refer you. So there should be an annual report by Ministry of Science and Technology. So there is something called annual report of Ministry of Science. Every ministry has its own annual report. So please make sure that you are referring that, you are reading that annual report. Okay, annual report of Ministry of Science and Technology. So you'll be getting a question from it. Annual report of Ministry of Science and Technology. Then in PAB, PAB, like every day there will be some question regarding article regarding science and technology in PAB, but it's not worth investing in PAB because it will take a great time. Rather, you go through some current affairs material which you have already finished. Then another important thing, in India yearbook, there will be a chapter specifically related to science and technology. Okay. In India yearbook, there is a specific chapter related to science and technology. Go through it. Okay. In India yearbook, there is a specific chapter related to science and technology. Go through it. Then bioweapons, if you are studying that MECR, multilateral export control regimes, you'll be covering that bioweapons. Okay. Can you tell about public health? Not actually, man. Ask me about science and technology related questions. I'll be discussing. Okay. Geography handouts, they're not given it. Will they be given us, sir? I don't know. You have to call, I'll update it. Okay. I'm not the person associated with geography. I'll be updating it. Then with previous strategy videos for 5 year modern history be uploaded on YouTube. Let me check it. I'm not sure about it. I'm not sure about it. Okay. See, all those which handout, I don't know about those handouts. I only know about my subject. Okay. So let me confirm with the authorities and let me tell you it again. Any specific doubts regarding this particular session? I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got many details, many data, many areas to focus on from this particular session, 2 hour session. Hope it benefited you. Okay. So go through it. Okay. So that's it about the session. Okay. So is there any other doubt? Otherwise we can finish the session. Then focus, if the exam is in October, focus till August. Give focus on August. Till August current affair. From last June to this August. Artificial intelligence, actually there was a question this year, that's why I skipped this time. Artificial intelligence was a question this time, that's why I skipped AI. Okay. Then more? Any other doubt? If you have doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, leave it. Digital strike of India against China? No. No. Joomla. Okay. Current affairs to be covered till August. Yes. Yes, so that's it. So if you're okay with your doubts, I believe there are no other doubts. So can I finish it? No, there won't be any session. I don't think so. There won't be any separate YouTube sessions. Okay. So all the materials will be shared in the group or in the channel. Don't worry. All the materials which I promised to give you will be giving in the group. And make sure that you are doing that daily practice questions which follows this one. Recorded one, I'm not sure about it. Let me ask the authorities. Okay. Recorder sessions will be there. I think recorder session will be there. This particular recorder sessions will be there. So that's it. That finishes the session. Okay. So I hope it's over. Thank you again. Okay, all the best for you.